Many people with COPD also have a history of smoking in the past or are still currently smoking. 9 out of 10 people who have lung cancer have had a history of smoking in the past. So today we're going to talk about lung cancer screening, and it might be very relevant for people with COPD because of their history of smoking. Screening for lung cancer means that we start looking for lung cancer in people who are at high risk so that we can find it in early stages even before they develop any signs and symptoms. All the major medical societies now endorse this lung cancer screening program because it has shown to reduce the mortality and the deaths because of lung cancer and can also be treated in early stages. I'm going to share with you the recommendations from the US Preventive Services Task Force. It recommends that lung cancer screening should be performed using a CT scan of the chest. A simple chest X-ray is not good enough to detect small spots of lung cancers in its early stages. Lung cancer screening is recommended for people who are 50 to 80 years of age and are currently smoking or have been smoking within the last 15 years. And throughout their lifetime, they have had an exposure of 20 pack years of smoking. Now, pack years is a way that we can tell how much smoking a person has done in their lifetime. And a pack year is calculated by the number of packs per day that you smoke for how many years you have smoked. For example, if someone smokes one pack of cigarette every day over 20 years, then this is 20 or more pack years. Or half a pack for 40 years is also 20 or more pack years. So this way we can have an idea of how much smoking exposure one person have had. Because the higher the exposure, the higher the risk of lung cancer. For people who meet these three criteria, it is recommended that they get a yearly CT scan of the chest. Now, this is a low-dose CT scan, so it's not too much radiation, and it can see if there are any spots in the lungs that can be suspicious for cancer. Now, having a spot or a nodule does not always mean it's cancer. Sometimes it may be because of some infection in the past or some other disease process, and it may just need to be watched over time. Now, based on the number of spots you have, the size of the spots, the location of the spots, your doctors will recommend what to do next. It could be that we just monitor this for some more time and do serial CT scans. It may be that we do a biopsy using a bronchoscopy or a CT scan, or it may be so suspicious that they might recommend surgery and to remove the spot. Many hospitals also offer a comprehensive lung cancer program and a lung nodule management program. So you don't have to worry about it, and they're going to track your progress, track your risk, and give you recommendations and remind you of what to do when. They also have a team of experts that deal with your case, and they can come up with the best solution, whether it's through further imaging and radiology, or if it's a pulmonologist doing a bronchoscopy or a procedure, or if it's a surgeon doing any intervention. I do want to acknowledge that dealing with the screening program and CT scan of the chest might become a bit stressful because you are uncertain of what they're going to find this time and what's going to be the next step. Dealing with this stress is much more better and easier compared to the stress of having a cancer that is now grown enough. Also keeping in mind that if the first CT scan is normal, that does not mean that cancer cannot develop in the future. So you should continue with the program as long as you are still in this criteria of 50 to 80 years of age, and it has been less than 15 years since you quit smoking. And lastly, it's very important for us to recognize that smoking is very dangerous for our health. And even if we quit today, it's going to help us a lot. As soon as you quit smoking, you will feel many health benefits. It includes benefits of reducing the risk of cancers, heart diseases, strokes. COPD itself gets benefit from you quitting smoking. Your symptoms get better, your flare-up risk goes down, and also the disease does not progress as fast. So if you quit smoking today, the risk of lung cancer within the next 10 years will be half of what it is today. So it's never too late to quit. And once it's been 15 years or more since you quit smoking, you can also stop your lung cancer screening program. I hope this information has now empowered you to have a better and meaningful conversations with your doctors. So go back to them and discuss if you need lung cancer screening. Check out our other videos to learn more about your COPD and lung health. And also look up our website, pepbuddy.com, to learn more about COPD care. And also check out our device, PEP Buddy, to see if it can help you breathe better, as it has helped many people with COPD.